We're joined again this morning by Aaron Conklin. Aaron is here to share a bevy of games with us, as you did last time. The first up on today's list is going to be Lego Harry Potter. Tell me a little bit about this franchise.
Sure. So this is the Lego series. This is actually the sixth game. There have been two based on Star Wars, two based on Indiana Jones, and one on Batman. And now, finally, Harry Potter gets his turn. I was a little worried that there wasn't going to be a lot new to offer here that would have seen it all. But there's a lot of magic in this game. It focuses on the content from the first four movies. And you can actually play through abbreviated versions of all four of them. But that's only about a third of what the game offers. There's all sorts of things to do. This is the kind of thing where you can sit down with your kids and really waste just hours of time having a blast.
Okay. Now, what is who is this game really designed for? Who is it going to cater to?
Well, it's a little of both. I mean, I think, you know, people who enjoy Harry Potter are really going to groove on it. There's a lot of sort of adult humor that's kind of, you know, little jokes that adults will get. But it's also really great to sit down and play with kids who like Legos, because there's a lot of, I mean, they use the spells to sort of build and recreate things and, you know, cast spells at things and discover coins that unlock new characters and new objects and that sort of thing. So it's sort of like a gigantic big treasure hunt for those who haven't played it before. Really entertaining.
What I think you said that's important there is it isn't just for kids. It looks like it's just for kids. You think Lego, you think Harry Potter, but I've played the Lego series in the past, and I got to tell you, I had a great time. So it's definitely not just for kids. So if you're an adult thinking about it, if you're on the fence, I think my recommendation would be go out there and snag it. All right, next game we're going to talk about, Crackdown 2. Tell me a little bit about this one.
Sure. So the first game came out a couple of years ago. You actually play as a super cop. Not quite a RoboCop, but a super cop who's challenged with cleaning up crime in the city. And the cool thing about it is that your powers are amazing. I mean, you know, really early in the game, you can jump, you know, 30 feet in the air, scale the sides of buildings, you know, throw cars. So the sequel is out now, and this one actually throws a couple of threats at you. During the day, you actually have to try and take care of a terrorist organization.
Okay.
At night, apparently half the city's been turned into these beastly zombies called freaks, and you have to take those guys down too. So this is a really great game to play with your friends, because if you can get three or four folks, each one with his own super agent, you can really do some major damage, throwing cars around and taking down the villains.
This sounds like it's geared a little bit more towards the adults.
It definitely is. This is a hardcore game, no question about it. There's a fair amount of violence, not necessarily a ton of blood, but there's a lot of violence, so definitely for the hardcore.
Final game, Puzzle Quest 2. Tell me a little bit about this one.
Sure. This is actually a pretty interesting game. It's a mix of the Match 3, the sort of thing that people are familiar with from Bejeweled, where you match three different gems, and also role-playing. So it's sort of a fantasy universe in which you play a hero who wanders around trying to save the city, and you encounter monsters that you have to actually beat in the Match 3 game.
Okay.
So you collect mana by matching the gems, and you can cast spells, you can power up weapons, and etc. So it's actually pretty entertaining, and for those who've tried Bejeweled and want something a little bit different, this is a good place to go.
Okay. And now all three of these games, are they out, being released? Where are they?
All three of them are out. Puzzle Quest 2 is available on Xbox Live and also on the Nintendo DS. Crackdown 2 is an Xbox exclusive, and Harry Potter Lego is available on PlayStation 3, Nintendo Wii, and the Xbox 360.
So if you're looking for something to do this weekend, you got a couple of hours free, maybe you go and rent or buy one of these games. Aaron,
absolutely,
we appreciate it. As always, we hope that you come back in and talk to us again about some more games.
I will. Thanks so much.
Thank you.